gratulacje, bo to za pana kadencji, jak rozumiem, ten deal, czy ta umowa prowadzenia teatru została sfinalizowana.
Tak, jak najbardziej, dziękuję. Więc moi poprzednicy zaczęli właśnie cały ten proces, ale właśnie dzisiaj widzimy kumulację tego, co właśnie oni zrobili.
Jeszcze raz, żeby przypomnieć, menadżer czy zarządzający innych teatrów tego typu, jak ten na przykład St. Charles, bierze to teraz w jak gdyby zarządzanie i będzie to niezwykle ważne źródło finansów dla miasta Des Plaines i przede wszystkim rozrywki dla mieszkańców.
Tak, jak najbardziej. Więc miasto wykupiło to miejsce, to jest własnością miasta, ale my nie będziemy tego operować. Nie jesteśmy w biznesie tego, żeby operować właśnie takie teatry, więc zatrudniliśmy pana Rana Onesti, który będzie operował. Więc to daliśmy mu klucze dzisiaj i on będzie robił z tym to, co wie jak najlepiej właśnie robić spektakle. Ten projekt by nie powstał, jeżeli by nam na przykład kasyno nie pomogło finansowo, bo jest naszym partnerem i tak samo Rana Onesti. To, co widzicie, te krzesła, wszystko, światła, głośniki, to wszystko jego inwestycje. My jako miasto żeśmy wyremontowali wszyściuteńko, ponad 6,5 miliona żeśmy wydali pieniążków podatnikami, więc wiemy, ile to jest dużo pieniędzy i wiemy, że staramy się jak najbardziej, żeby ten teatr dał radę, żeby było jak najwięcej spektakli, żeby to się po prostu zwróciło. I to się stanie, ponieważ ten teatr będzie takim zapalnikiem, że tak powiem, downtown, żeby ludzie nie tylko z Des Plaines, ale z okolic przyjeżdżali właśnie do Des Plaines, żeby zjeść, zobaczyć show i powiedzieć znajomym, hej, fajnie jest w Des Plaines, przyjeżdżajcie, bo jak wiemy, Des Plaines przez te parę dekad było takim zapomnianym dzieckiem, że tak powiem. Park Ridge, Des Plaines się rozbudowało, Des Plaines było zapomniane, więc mamy nadzieję, że właśnie ten teatr będzie tym, że postawi Des Plaines na mapce.
Właśnie to chciałem zapytać. Pickwick Theater ma poważnego rywala.
Jak najbardziej.
Mayor Gaszkowski, congratulations. I mean, bringing people together in times of pandemic, bringing tax revenue back to Des Plaines. What else could we wish for?
Well, I am wishing for this to take off and be crazy successful. I want to see businesses popping up all over the place. I'm really looking forward to it.
And we see strong Polish representation, which is obvious in a town that has almost 25% of Polish population.
Absolutely. As a proud Polish American, I'm so proud to serve along Arthur Zadrozny, Jessica Mastowski. We have a really strong contingent here. And you know, if you're Polish American and you want somewhere to settle down, come look at Des Plaines. It's a great place to live.
Tony Aridia, the mayor at that time, this was back in 2004. He called a town hall meeting. He had this vision about a new theater district. Actually, the Des Plaines Theater was going to be part of it, and the Theater Guild building across the street was going to be a dinner playhouse. Okay, obviously that didn't all happen, but when we're in the middle of planning all this, Mount Prospect National Bank put an offer in to buy the property, and they were going to tear it down to build a drive-through banking facility. That got the residents up in arms because we didn't want to see this beautiful building torn down for another drive-through banking facility. So that's when the Des Plaines Theater Preservation Society was born.
Here we are.
And here we are today. We actually petitioned the council to buy the building and let us run it for them. They could have got the building for $660,000 at that time, but they didn't think that was a viable way to go, so they didn't do it. Instead, they paid the Indian gentleman after he bought it to $1.2 million. But the good news is the city of Des Plaines bought it, and the casino came in. The casino brought in some money. We got Ron Onesti involved, and he contributed some money. And now this is going to be a viable entertainment venue for downtown Des Plaines, which is going to do what we always wanted it to do. We wanted it to be a catalyst for economic development in downtown Des Plaines.
And especially needed right now.
Right. Well, put it this way. Des Plaines right now, downtown, is far better than it was 20 years ago. Okay, but now with this, it's even gonna get better.
Jessica, congratulations, what a wonderful venue. I mean, this is what we need in times of reopening from pandemic. We need revenue, we need some place to gather, to congregate, to be with one another.
Completely, it brings together the community, it brings together a focal point for our downtown area, which we hope will be thriving and vibrant, and can't wait to see what is, or at least myself, I can't wait to see what's the upcoming for displays and all that we have to offer.
And speaking of you, you are of Polish ancestry. A quarter of displays population is Polish American.
I am proud to be part of that Polish American community in Des Plaines. It's wonderful that our heritage and our background and our connection to being Polish American and how Polish is our roots and in our American community here.
I love my Polish cousins. I really, Polish, Italian, so similar in culture.
What does this opening mean to you personally?
Well, as I said on stage, you know, Serge, I consider this a responsibility. This is something that's been open and closed and open and closed, and it means so much to the people in this community. Whether you're Polish, Italian, or anything else, it means a lot. I recognize that, I understand it, and I'm going to bring to it the splendor that it once had in the 1920s.
High-quality entertainment. What are we going to see right here in this place?
Well, big names, and you're going to see a variety. And look at just our opening week. We're opening with the A-lister Hollywood star Kevin Costner. The next night is Paul Anka. Then we have the guys from the Electric Light Orchestra, Amy Grant, Kenny Wayne Shepherd. That's just the first week.
Excellent. Thank you so much, and we appreciate you being part of this community. It seems like places like this are more important than ever in these crazy times.
You nailed it 100%. This is more important than ever to keep these old places full of history alive, just like keeping our cultures alive.